my friend whose hands were so tight. Drum roll, please. Ayana Kamana.
Oh, and go, Ayana.
All right, scholars. Ayana is going to be our mom. So she starts with how much money? What's the first part in our story? How much does she start with? Andre. How much does she start with? She starts with 84 cents. I'm going to give Ayana 84 cents. It's not really 84 cents. It's just approximately. So she's going to hold them in her fake purse, which is really just her hands. So then she has 84 cents. What happens next in our story, Kevin? Your hands are still folded. So yeah, she found some more pennies, some more cents. Where did she find them, Andrea? Oh, I love how she's looking back in her story.
Ooh, not in her purse. It says, Mom finds 13 cents under the sofa cushion.
So, she's gonna find 13 more cents. She's gonna bend down and look for her 13 cents. Oh, and look, she finds 13 more cents. Now, she has 84 and then the 13 she found. I need hands folded tight. Yes, Andre, back. Thank you. Get there all the way. Put them down. Azalea, check. Put them down. Yeah, so now she has 84 cents and the 13. What happens next, Keyshawn?
Thank you.
Brilliant Scholars, I saw us representing in a couple different ways. Kevin, can you tell us what was your representation for this problem? Nice and loud. I love how Xavier is tracking. What does that represent? Miguel, I see. She wanted to buy a peach. So what does the 35 represent? Can you help him out, Janachi? What does 35 represent?
The
cents she has left, right? Until you throw it away.
Okay.
How many cents she has left? And that equals what? So if we have how many she has after she found them in the couch, subtract 35, which is what she has left. What does it equal, Deshaun?
We don't know.
We don't know, but what does it represent? What is that? Paid? How much she paid? So we have to figure out two things. That's why we have two variables. We have an M and we have a P. When I say go, silently fix your representation. Get ready? Go. Deshaun is silently fixing his. Miguel, I need your pencil moving. Your pencils are down in 10. Get there in 9. 8. 7. Hands are folded. 6. 5. 4. Ooh, row 2 is almost all there. 1. Let me see it. And 0. Good morning. Oh, no, we're not making a sound. We're just going to do better next time. No. Okay.
got you 4 plus 3 is
7.
And then 80 plus 10 is
9. Oh,
90. So your total was
97.
So this is his M. How much mom had? That's why he drew an arrow and put it over here. So then he has 97 and he took 35 away. Why did you take 35 away? Your hands are still folded. I'll give you time in a moment.
Because
she bought a peach. So we have to take it away because it got smaller. I need two friends in the back to fold their hands. Thank you. Took it away. 7 minus 5 got you 2. 90 minus 30 got you 60. How much cents did mom pay for her peach, Andre?
62.
Check your work. Yeah. Fix it if it's wrong. Silently fixing your work. If you got it right, check your labels. Put your papers down. Oh, freeze. Hands on heads, tracking me. 3, 2, 1, 0. Scholars, I said silent. When you fix your work, you are not talking. You are silently fixing it. Try again. Go. Ooh, yeah, you're silent. Trinity, check, hold. All right, my friends.
want you to take 2 minutes to represent. To
represent
with your partner. Oh, all hands are folded. Don't get tricked. Wait till I say go.
This amount of
subtract. Is my B smaller or bigger than my red crayons? Raise your hand if you think we should add. Raise your hand if we think we should subtract. Ooh, yeah, we're gonna subtract. Go ahead and silently fix your first part of the story. Oh, freeze, hands on heads. 3, 2, 1, 0, Troy. Jack, turn your voice off. Janash. Scholars, I said silent. There is no sound. Miguel. Silently correct the first part. Go. Troy is silently writing. Keyshawn is silently writing.
All right, scholars. We are not going to solve this yet. Kaylee and Trinity. All right, scholars. First, when we're solving our number stories problems, what steps do we take? What steps do we take? Turn and tell your partner and go. What steps do we take? Alright, scholars, so Soraya, what did you say?